Now let's start with chapter Europe, and you know it very well. This chapter will come in paper in the form of MCQ. So no need to prepare subjective questions. You have to do this chapter in the form of MCQ. And for MCQ, you have to do thorough reading of this chapter. And this chapter starts with the four prints of Frederick Soriot. So one more question can be asked, who was Frederick Soriot? Now do this chapter in the form of MCQ. He was French artist. Jaise main bolu, he was Frederick Soriot was German artist, hai na, Russian artist, French artist. So you have to take French artist. So in the form of MCQ, he prepared series of four prints in 1848. For example, मैं आपको बोलूं prepared series of four prints in 1847, 1846, 1848. तो correct answer is 1848. So in this way you have to prepare the questions. And here Statue of Liberty, it will be easy for you to do MCQ because you have done this chapter thoroughly. आप कर चुके हो and you have done this chapter in PT 1 also. So you have done subjective questions also from this chapter. So it will not difficult for you to prepare MCQs. Next is Frederick Soriot में से ही artist showed here. Frederick Soriot showed liberty in the form of female figure, torch of enlightenment in one hand and charter of rights in the other hand. Countries of Europe and America were going towards, people of different ages were going towards Statue of Liberty to show their homage. And here artist showed liberty in the form of female figure. One more question can be asked from this. And leading the procession were United States and Switzerland. Ye bhi one more question ban sakta hai. And Germany, people of different countries, they identified through their costumes and through their flag. As they were going in the form of procession, they were identified through their costumes and through their flag. Because in this paragraph only the color of the flag of Germany is given. ठीक है, तो आपको ये पूछा जा सकता है color of the flag of Germany, red, black and gold. Red, black and gold, you have to learn the color of the flag of Germany. Red, black, gold, learn it. Okay, red, black and gold. And next, from the heaven angels Christ gazed upon this scene symbolized fraternity. Fraternity means brotherhood. So इसके बाद आपका आ जाता है what is nation state. Nation state is a state in which people have common identity, shared history and common ancestors. ठीक है, next, what do you mean by utopian? Vision of society that is so ideal that never exists. Vision of the society that is so ideal that never exists. Absolutist means, what do you mean by absolutist? Absolutist means powers in one hand. Utopian means vision of the society that is so ideal that never exists. And absolutist means powers in one hand. Who was Ernest Renan? Because only one chapter is there in PT 2. The first term you are having only one chapter, so that's why you have to read it thoroughly. Side pe jo paragraphs, jo pics bhi di hui hain, aapko unki bhi reading karni hai. Questions can be framed from the paragraphs which are given on the side of the chapter or the pics which are given. Some images are given on the side of the chapter. You have to read those also. One mark questions unse unme se bhi ban jane hain. So Ernest Renan dekhna, side pe ek paragraph diya hua hai. He was lecturer in Sorbonne University. Ernest Renan was, who was Ernest Renan? He was lecturer. Lecturer था Sorbonne University में. Lecturer in Sorbonne, मैं आपको भी दिखाती हूँ कहाँ पे ये paragraph दिया हुआ है, so that you have an idea how to prepare. Look here, it's given here. साइड पे जो पैराग्राफ दिया हुआ है उसमें से भी क्वेश्चंस बन जाने हैं. ही वाज लेक्चरर इन सोर्बन यूनिवर्सिटी, या फिर अर्नेस्ट रेनन वाज जर्मन फिलोसोफर और फ्रेंच फिलोसोफर. फ्रेंच फिलोसोफर, ही वाज फ्रेंच फिलोसोफर. ही वॉज फ्रेंच फिलोसफर. तो क्वेश्चन इस तरह के क्वेश्चन भी बन जाने. यू कैन सी हियर द पैराग्राफ इज गिवन. सो टेक रीडिंग ऑफ दिस पैराग्राफ. ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं आपने छोड़ना. नेक्स्ट, प्लेबिस्काइट वर्ड इज गिवन. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय प्लेबिस्काइट. बुक में जो भी दिया मैं वो नहीं आंसर बोल रही हूँ, मैं अपने वैसे बता रही हूँ. इट इज अ डायरेक्ट वोट बाय विच होल इलेक्टोरेट इज आस्क्ड टू एक्सेप्ट और रिजेक्ट द प्रपोजल. प्लेबिस्काइट मीन्स, प्लेबिस्काइट का अगर मीनिंग पूछना चाहे तो आपने बताना है डायरेक्ट वोट बाय विच होल इलेक्टोरेट इज आस्क्ड टू एक्सेप्ट और रिजेक्ट द प्रपोजल. इज इट क्लियर. नेक्स्ट, एक आपको दिया हुआ है सफरेज शायद. तो नेक्स्ट इज लुक हियर फर्स्ट, एब्सोल्यूटिस्ट अटोपियन. वी हैव डन बोथ एंड फ्रॉम दिस पेज वी हैव डन वन मोर क्वेश्चन. कलर ऑफ द फ्लैग ऑफ जर्मनी अर्नेस्ट रेनन एंड देन यू हैव डन प्लेबिस्काइट डायरेक्ट वोट बाय विच होल इलेक्टोरेट इज आस्क्ड टू एक्सेप्ट और रिजेक्ट द प्रपोजल. नेक्स्ट इज वन मोर क्वेश्चन, इन विच ईयर देयर वॉज रेवोल्यूशन इन फ्रांस. 1789 यू हैव रेड इन नाइन्थ क्लास ऑल्सो. विच वॉज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पोलिटिकल क्लब ऑफ फ्रांस एज द नेम इज गिवन इन दिस पैराग्राफ. तो दे कैन आस्क जैकोबिन क्लब. ओनली द नेम्स आर गिवन, नॉट डिटेल इज गिवन हियर बिकॉज यू हैव रेड इन नाइन्थ क्लास. देयर वॉज रेवोल्यूशन इन फ्रांस इन 1789 एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट पोलिटिकल क्लब ऑफ फ्रांस वॉज जैकोबिन क्लब. और फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशनरी स्टेटेड यू हैव डन दिस टॉपिक. क्योंकि ये सब्जेक्टिव फॉर्म में क्वेश्चन नहीं आना तो फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक वन मार्क क्वेश्चंस कैन बी आस्क्ड. और फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशनरी स्टेटेड सेंस ऑफ कलेक्टिव आइडेंटिटी अमंग अस पीपल. आइडिया ऑफ लॉ पैट्री यू हैव डन. लॉ पैट्री, लॉ पैट्री का मीनिंग आना चाहिए. द फादरलैंड, ली सिटेयोन, द सिटीजन. आइडिया ऑफ लॉ पैट्री, ली सिटेयोन, इनके मीनिंग आने चाहिए. वन मार्क क्वेश्चन में पूछ सकते हैं लॉ पैट्री मीन्स. लॉ पैट्री मीन्स द फादरलैंड. ली सिटीजन मीन्स द सिटीजन. तो इस तरह के क्वेश्चंस दे कैन आस्क फ्रॉम दिस पैराग्राफ. एंड हियर कवर ऑफ जर्मन अल्मैनिक. अल्मैनिक होता है कैलेंडर. कैलेंडर जिसमें एनुअल कैलेंडर आप कह सकते हो. कैलेंडर, एनुअल कैलेंडर डिजाइंड बाय जर्नलिस्ट. तो जर्नलिस्ट का नाम पूछ सकते हैं. हु डिजाइंड जर्मन अल्मैनिक. So name of the Andreas Rebmann. Name of the person is given here, Andreas Rebmann. Name of the person who designed German Almanac. Who designed German Almanac? Andreas Rebmann. Because there is only one chapter in first term na. So idhar se unhone questions 100% dal dene. Ek hi chapter hai to wo ek aise hi thoda straight forward question dal denge. Idhar se bhi dal denge aapko. स्टूडेंट्स ने थोरो रीडिंग किया कि नहीं चैप्टर की. तो एंड्रियस रेबमैन यू हैव टू लर्न. नेक्स्ट, यहाँ पे आपको फ्रेंच, विच लैंग्वेज वॉज अडॉप्टेड. फ्रेंच, फ्रेंच बिकेम मेन लैंग्वेज. रेस्ट ऑफ द लैंग्वेजेस वर डिस्करेज. विच फ्लैग वॉज अडॉप्टेड बाय फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशनरीज. ट्राई कलर फ्लैग वॉज अडॉप्टेड बाय फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशनरीज. And French army moved to which countries? You have done. कर चुके हो आप. Belgium, Holland and Switzerland, later Italy. Name the countries where French army moved. Belgium, Holland, Switzerland, later Italy. You have done it before. French army moved to the countries Belgium, Holland, Switzerland, later Italy. अगर cities पूछें, Mainz, Milan, Warsaw and Brussels. Mainz, Milan, Warsaw and Brussels. Brussels is the capital of Belgium. Brussels is the capital of Belgium. So ye aapko cities and countries dono batani chahiye. So French army, why French army was welcome? Because carried with it the idea of nation state and helped the country to get freedom from despotic rule. Help the country to get freedom from despotic rule. One more question, what do you mean by suffrage? Suffrage means right to vote. Suffrage means, what do you mean by suffrage? Suffrage means right to vote. So here some one more questions are given. In which year Napoleon invaded Italy? 1799, 1815, 1815, 1797, in which year Napoleon invaded Italy? 1797. So you have to learn. First of all, we will do Napoleonic code. Who was Napoleon? Ruler of France. Who was Napoleon? Ruler of France. In which year he issued civil codes? 1804. In which year Napoleon issued civil codes? 1804. And he removed guild restrictions. Guild, I have told you in chapter Industrialization, Association of Traders. You have done before in the chapter Industrialization, meaning of guild. Guilds means Association of Traders. Napoleon removed restrictions from the guilds. Freedom of trade was given. So Napoleonic code, aapko year pata hona chahiye. Who was Napoleon? Pata hona chahiye. Who was Napoleon? Ruler of France. Earlier he was military dictator, but later he became the ruler of France. In which year he became the ruler? 1804. Who issued civil codes? Napoleon. And aapko ye bhi pucha ja sakta hai ki Napoleon got defeated in Battle of Waterloo. In which year? 1815 में उसे बैटल ऑफ वाटरलू में हरा दिया था. नेम द कंट्रीज दैट डिफीटेड नेपोलियन दैट और साइन द ट्रीटी ऑफ वियना. तो कंट्रीज पता होनी चाहिए. दोनों का आंसर इज सेम, ऑस्ट्रिया, ब्रिटेन, रशिया एंड प्रशिया. ए बी आर पी, ऑस्ट्रिया, ब्रिटेन, रशिया, प्रशिया. ऑस्ट्रिया, ब्रिटेन, रशिया एंड प्रशिया डिफीटेड नेपोलियन इन द बैटल ऑफ वाटरलू. एंड ट्रीटी ऑफ वियना भी जब साइन हुई तो दैट वाज साइन बिटवीन दीज कंट्रीज. विच वर द कंट्रीज? ऑस्ट्रिया, ब्रिटेन, रशिया एंड प्रशिया. सो यू हैव टू लर्न लाइक दिस नेपोलियनिक कोड. वन मार क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक. एंड नेक्स्ट इज हियर few questions are given. In which year Napoleon invaded Italy? 1797. Only one question you have to learn, rest you have done. आपको अपने आप आपने किए होंगे, आगे जाके ये क्वेश्चन आपने किए हुए हैं. Habsburg Empire was patchwork of number of regions. अब ये टॉपिक है तो इसमें वन मार्क क्वेश्चन कौन से बनते हैं. पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन ऑफ जर्मनी, पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन ऑफ जर्मनी किंगडम, पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन ऑफ स्विट्जरलैंड कैंटन, पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन ऑफ स्विट्जरलैंड. जैसे हम इंडिया की कहते हैं पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन ऑफ इंडिया स्टेट, इंडिया की पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन क्या है? स्टेट्स. तो वैसे ही मैं बोलूँ जर्मनी की पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन किंगडम, पॉलिटिकल डिवीजन ऑफ स्विट्जरलैंड कैंटन, कैंटन, इटली डचेस, स्विट्जरलैंड कैंटन, जर्मनी किंगडम. So this is the political division of Germany, Italy and Switzerland. पहले तो हमने किया था ना subjective question में कि Germany, Italy and Switzerland were divided into smaller parts. But अब आपको one mark में पूछा जा सकता है name the political division of Italy. So Duchess, name the political division of Switzerland, cantons, name the political division of Germany, kingdoms. So one mark questions can be framed from this topic. Habsburg Empire was patchwork of number of regions ruled over Austria and Hungary. Country पूछी जा सकती है. Habsburg Empire ruled over Austria and Hungary. Austria and Hungary. It included Alpine regions. Which regions? Alpine regions. अब आपसे Alpine regions पूछे जा सकते हैं. Alpine regions, the Tyrol, Austria and Sudetenland. The Tyrol, Austria and Sudetenland. ये कर चुके हो आप सारे. Habsburg Empire was patchwork of number of regions ruled over Austria and Hungary. Ruled over Austria and Hungary. Included which regions? Alpine regions. अब Alpine regions क्या थे? The Tyrol, Austria, Sudetenland. As well as Bohemia, the Tyrol, Sudetenland, Austria. So ये आपसे पूछे जा सकते हैं, ठीक है. अब languages, for example आपसे पूछा जा सकता है. In Hungary, half of the population spoke Magyar. Which language? Magyar. Hungary में half of the population spoke Magyar. And then next is In Galicia, Polish language. In Galicia, which language was spoken by aristocrats? Polish. Hungary mein half of the population spoke Magyar. Magyar, which language? Magyar. And then in aap kahoge Galicia, Galicia ki language aap bataoge Polish. Aristocrats in Galicia spoke which language? Polish language. Which language? Polish language. Hungary ki half of the population spoke Galicia. Is it clear? Magyar, sorry. Hungary ki half of the population spoke Magyar. And aristocrats, agar main puchhun ke aristocrats jo the Galicia ke, they spoke Polish. So ye one more questions ban jane isme se, you have to learn. Next, aristocracy and new middle class. So isme se aapko pucha ja sakta hai, to the west land was formed by tenants and small land owners. To the west of Europe, land was cultivated by tenants. To the west of Europe, land was cultivated by tenants. जो लोग landless होते थे तो कोई rent पे land लेते थे. Or small land owners. To the east, land was. To the east, there were large estates. To the east, there were large estates. So land was cultivated by serfs. To the east, there were vast estates. So land was cultivated by serfs. Who cultivated land in the west? Tenants or small land owners? And in the east of Europe, serfs. In the east of Europe, serfs, because there were large estates. So next is liberalism. Liberalism is taken from Latin word meaning free. Liberalism is taken from Latin word meaning free. One more question. Latin word meaning free. So yahan pe one more question hai. Suffrage means right to vote. Suffrage means right to vote. Ab next is sovereign. It was custom union. You have done it. You have done this topic. What was sovereign? It was custom union. In which year sovereign was passed? 1834 with the initiative of Prussia. Sovereign was passed in 1834 with the initiative of Prussia. Is it clear? Sovereign was passed in 1834 with the initiative of Prussia. It was custom union. It was custom union. For the measurement of clothes, what was taken in those days? Ile. For the ile was taken for the measurement of cloth. E double L E, ile. Ile was taken for the measurement of cloth. In ile, number of centimeters were not same. In ile, number of centimeters were not same. इले का पूछ सकते हैं सॉल्वेंट क्या था कस्टम यूनियन तो क्या हाउ मेनी कस्टम बैरियर्स ट्रेडर्स हैड टू क्लियर 11 कस्टम बैरियर्स हाउ मच परसेंट कस्टम ड्यूटीज दे हैड टू पे 5% कस्टम ड्यूटी एट ईच बैरियर इज इट क्लियर ट्रेडर्स हैड टू क्लियर इन दोज डेज इन 1833 ट्रेडर्स ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम हैमबर्ग टू नूरेमबर्ग हैड टू क्लियर 11 custom barriers and at each barrier they had to pay 5% custom duty. So ye aapko pucha ja sakta na 1833 mein traders traveling from Hamburg to Nuremberg how many custom barriers were cleared by them 11 how much custom duty they had to pay 5% custom duty. So fir next is ke sovereign ke agar ek bhi jaise number of currencies after the coming of sovereign नंबर ऑफ currencies लेफ्ट ओनली टू 30 से कितनी रह गई टू When Zolprin was passed, number of currencies reduced from 32 to 30 से कितनी रहेगी number of currencies? 2. ये भी वर्मा क्वेश्चन में पूछा जा सकता है. Number of currencies left after the introduction of Zolprin कितनी रहेगी number of currencies? 2. Earlier the number of currencies was 30, but now it left only 2. So these are the Vanma questions from Zolprin. It was custom union passed with the initiative of Prussia in 1834. फिर आपको बताना चाहिए कि ट्रेडर्स जो हैमबर्ग से न्यूरेमबर्ग जाते थे 1833, कितने कस्टम बैरियर्स, कितनी परसेंट ड्यूटी एंड नंबर ऑफ करेंसीज आफ्टर द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ जॉलब्रिन, नंबर ऑफ करेंसीज लेफ्ट ओनली 2. अर्लियर इट वाज 30 बोला मैंने, 30 से 2 रह गई नंबर ऑफ करेंसीज. सो दिस इज अबाउट जॉलब्रिन. नेक्स्ट इज कंजर्वेटिज्म. Conservatism, a political philosophy that laid stress on past institution believed in the powers of church. So in those days, Europe was driven by revolutionaries or conservatives? Conservatives. In those days, Europe was driven by conservatives. Who were powerful in Europe? Conservatives. कौन powerful थे? Conservatives. बाद में रेवोल्यूशनरीज वगैरह पॉपुलर होते चले गए ना. अर्लियर कंजर्वेटिज्म वाज देयर इन यूरोप. सो कंजर्वेटिव्स बिलीव्ड इन द पावर्स ऑफ चर्च एंड रिस्पेक्टेड द पास्ट इंस्टीट्यूशंस. नेक्स्ट कंट्रीज दैट डिफीट साइन द ट्रीटी ऑफ वियना, ऑस्ट्रिया, ब्रिटेन, रशिया एंड प्रशिया. इन विच ईयर ट्रीटी ऑफ वियना वाज साइंड? 1815. बिकॉज यू हैव डन सब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन सो आई थिंक इट विल बिकम इजी फॉर यू टू लर्न. Treaty of Vienna was signed in 1815 between whom? Austria, Britain, Russia and Prussia. Inhi countries ne Napoleon ko haraya tha. They met at Vienna to sign the Treaty of Vienna. Ab Vienna is the capital of Austria. Vienna is the capital of Austria. One more question. Vienna is the capital of Austria. Who was the host of this treaty? Duke Metternich. Who was the host of this treaty? Duke Metternich. Who was Duke Metternich? Revolutionary, conservative or liberal? Conservative. Duke Metternich was conservative and he was Chancellor of Austria because this treaty was signed in Vienna and Vienna is the capital of Austria and Duke Metternich was the Chancellor of Austria just like Prime Minister of Austria. So, kyunki host tha wo. Duke Metternich was the host and Austrian Chancellor and he was conservative by nature. Duke Metternich was conservative by nature. अब आपको पूछा जा सकता है जैसे हमने इसमें किया हुआ है terms में से कितने questions बन जाने हैं. जैसे Poland was given to Russia. North Italy, Austria. North Italy was given to Austria. Saxony was given to Prussia. So you have to learn these also. Poland was given to Russia. North Italy was given to Austria. And Saxony was given to Prussia. So you have to make one more questions from this topic. Treaty of Vienna में से कितने questions आपके बन जाने हैं? One mark. Terms आपने की हुई हैं. Terms में से ही आपके questions बन के आ जाने हैं. Yes, what was the main aim of this treaty? To restore Bourbon dynasty. To restore Bourbon dynasty. Louis XVI belonged to which dynasty? Bourbon dynasty. And the main aim of the Treaty of Vienna was to restore Bourbon dynasty. किसको वापस पावर में लाना चाहते थे? Bourbon dynasty को वापस पावर में लाना चाहते थे. And यहाँ पे एक क्वेश्चन है Friedrich List. Look here, see this paragraph. Friedrich List. Friedrich List. Who was Friedrich List? Professor of Economics. Professor of Economics at Tübingen University in Germany. At Tübingen University in Germany. Who was Friedrich List? Friedrich List was professor. Professor tha economics ka. In Tübingen University of Germany. Professor of Economics in Tübingen University of Germany. Is it clear? So learn these questions for one mark. Aaj ab itne hi karte hain.